All right, folks. Let's talk about a group of unsung heroes who have been hiding in plain sight, the hidden figures of American history. And no, I'm not talking about the math problem you skipped in high school. I'm talking about the incredible contributions of Black women in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, STEM. These women were pioneers in their fields, breaking barriers and shattering stereotypes to make their mark on history. But for too long, their stories have been overlooked and ignored. It's like when you're at a party and you're telling a hilarious joke, but no one hears it because they're all too busy taking selfies. The contributions of these hidden figures have been drowned out by the noise of a society that has often failed to recognize the talent and potential of Black women. But that's where Hidden Figures comes in. This film tells the true story of three Black women who worked at NASA during the space race and who played a critical role in putting the first American man in space. And let me tell you, their stories are nothing short of inspiring. We have Katherine Johnson, a human computer who calculated the trajectories for the first American manned space flights. It's like she had a superpower for math, but instead of using it to fight crime, she used it to help put a man on the moon. Then there's Mary Jackson, the first Black female engineer at NASA. She had to fight for her education, petitioning a Virginia court for permission to attend a segregated school to get the necessary qualifications to become an engineer. It's like she had to navigate an obstacle course just to get to the starting line, but she never gave up. And let's not forget about Dorothy Vaughn, who led the West Computing Group, a team of Black women who were responsible for programming and operating the first electronic computers at NASA. It's like she was the captain of a team that was making history, but no one knew about it. These women faced discrimination, prejudice, and a society that was not yet ready to recognize their talent and potential. But they persevered, breaking down barriers and making history in the process. Their stories are a reminder of the power of determination, hard work, and grit. So buckle up, folks, because we're about to take a journey through history, exploring the amazing contributions of the hidden figures of American history. Get ready to be inspired, entertained, and maybe even a little bit angry that these stories haven't been told sooner. But most importantly, get ready to learn and grow and discover the amazing potential that exists in all of us, no matter who we are or where we come from. All right, folks, let's talk about Katherine Johnson, the human computer who helped put a man on the moon. If you've never heard of her, don't worry, you're not alone. Katherine's contributions to the space program were largely overlooked for decades, and it's time to give her the recognition she deserves. Katherine was born in 1918 in West Virginia. Even as a child, she showed an incredible talent for mathematics, and by the time she was in high school, she was already taking college-level courses. It's like she was a math genius from birth, and no one even bothered to read the manual. After graduating from college, Katherine began working at NASA's predecessor, the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, NACA. She started out as a computer, which was a job title for women who performed calculations by hand. It's like she was a human calculator, but instead of buttons, she had fingers. Katherine quickly proved herself to be a valuable asset to the agency, and in 1953, she was transferred to the Flight Research Division. It's like she got called up to the big leagues, and she was ready to play ball. It was in the Flight Research Division that Katherine made her most significant contributions to the space program. She was responsible for calculating the trajectories for the first American manned space flights, including John Glenn's historic orbit around the Earth. It's like she had the power to plot the course of history, and she did it with nothing more than a pencil and a piece of paper. But it wasn't just her mathematical skills that made Katherine such an incredible asset to the space program. It was her perseverance in the face of discrimination and prejudice. As a Black woman working in a predominantly white male field, Katherine faced constant obstacles and challenges, but she never let those obstacles stop her from achieving her goals. In fact, when NASA first began using electronic computers to perform calculations, Katherine was asked to verify the results. It's like they were using a calculator to check her work, but she still came out on top. And let's not forget about the scene in the movie Hidden Figures where Katherine had to run across the NASA campus to use a colored bathroom. It's like they were trying to make her run a marathon just to pee, but she still made it back in time to crunch the numbers for the next space flight. Katherine's contributions to the space program have not gone unnoticed, however. In 2015, she was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by President Barack Obama. And in 2016, NASA named a research facility after her, the Katherine G. Johnson Computational Research Facility. It's like they finally realized that Katherine was more than just a human calculator. She was a trailblazer who changed the course of history. This is the incredible story of Katherine Johnson, the human computer who helped put a man on the moon. Her perseverance, talent, and determination in the face of discrimination and prejudice are an inspiration to us all. Now let's talk about Mary Jackson, the first black female engineer at NASA. If you haven't heard of her, you're missing out on a story of perseverance, dedication, and a whole lot of brains. Mary was born in Hampton, Virginia in 1921, and from a young age she had a passion for math and science. It's like she had a built-in calculator in her brain, and she was always ready to use it. But despite her talent and drive, Mary faced obstacles at every turn. As a black woman living in the Jim Crow South, she was denied many opportunities that were available to white men. It's like she was running a race with a ball and chain attached to her ankle, but she never gave up. Mary attended Hampton University, where she earned a degree in math and physical science. But it wasn't until she started working at NASA's predecessor, the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, NACA, that she truly began to shine. At NACA, Mary worked as a mathematician, analyzing data from wind tunnel tests on aircraft. But she soon realized that if she wanted to advance in her career, she would need to become an engineer. It's like she was playing chess, and she had to make the right move to get to the other side of the board. But becoming an engineer was no easy feat, especially for a black woman in the 1950s. Mary had to petition a Virginia court for permission to attend a segregated school that offered the courses she needed to become an engineer. It's like she was playing a game of Mother May I, but instead of taking a step forward, she had to take three steps back just to get in the game. Mary eventually earned her engineering degree and became NASA's first black female engineer. But her contributions to the space program didn't stop there. She went on to work on the Apollo program, helping to develop the heat shields that protected the spacecraft during re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. It's like she was a superhero, using her powers to save the day. Mary's story is a reminder of the power of determination and hard work. She faced discrimination and prejudice at every turn, but she never gave up on her dreams. And her legacy lives on today as an inspiration to young girls and women of color who are pursuing careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. In fact, in 2019, NASA named its headquarters building after Mary Jackson. It's like they finally realized that Mary was more than just a mathematician or an engineer. She was a trailblazer who paved the way for generations to come. So that is the amazing story of Mary Jackson, the first black female engineer at NASA. Her perseverance, dedication, and talent are an inspiration to us all. Next, folks, let's talk about Dorothy Vaughn, the mathematician and computer programmer who led the West Computing Group at NASA. If you haven't heard of her, you're in for a real treat. Dorothy was born in 1910 in Kansas, and from a young age, she showed a talent for math. It's like she was born with a calculator in her hand, ready to crunch some numbers. But despite her talent, Dorothy faced discrimination and prejudice throughout her career. She started out as a math teacher, but when she moved to Virginia in the 1940s, she found that there were few opportunities for black women in education. It's like she was playing a game of whack-a-mole, trying to find a job that wouldn't discriminate against her based on her race and gender. Eventually, Dorothy landed a job at NASA's predecessor, the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, NACA, where she worked as a human computer. It's like she was a robot, but instead of being made of metal and wires, she was made of flesh and blood. But when NASA started using electronic computers to perform calculations, Dorothy saw an opportunity. She taught herself how to program the IBM computers, and before long, she was leading the West Computing Group, a team of black women who were responsible for programming and operating the first electronic computers at NASA. It's like she was a superhero, leading a team of sidekicks to save the day. But Dorothy faced more than just technological challenges. She also had to navigate a society that was not yet ready to recognize the talent and potential of black women. In fact, in the movie Hidden Figures, we see Dorothy being denied access to the library, where the programming books were kept because of her race. It's like they were trying to keep her from achieving her full potential, but she wasn't having any of it. Despite these obstacles, Dorothy persevered, paving the way for generations of women of color in STEM fields. And her legacy lives on today as an inspiration to anyone who has ever faced discrimination or prejudice. In fact, in 2019, NASA named a building after Dorothy Vaughn, the Katherine G. Johnson Computational Research Facility. It's like they finally realized that Dorothy was more than just a computer programmer. She was a trailblazer who changed the course of history. That's the incredible story of Dorothy Vaughn, the mathematician and computer programmer who led the West Computing Group at NASA. Her perseverance, talent, and determination in the face of discrimination and prejudice are an inspiration to us all. Hidden Figures is a 2016 biographical drama film based on the true stories of Katherine Johnson, Mary Jackson, and Dorothy Vaughn, three black women who made significant contributions to NASA's space program during the 1960s. The film highlights the discrimination and obstacles they faced as women of color in a predominantly white male field and their perseverance and determination to overcome them. Hidden Figures has been praised for bringing attention to the untold stories of these remarkable women and inspiring a new generation to pursue careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. First of all, the film brought the stories of Katherine Johnson, Mary Jackson, and Dorothy Vaughn to a wider audience. It's like they went from being hidden figures to being the stars of the show. But the impact of the film didn't stop there. It also highlighted the importance of diversity and inclusion in STEM fields. It's like the movie was a beacon of hope, shining a light on the potential of women and people of color in science, technology, engineering, and math. And let's not forget about the impact on the next generation. The film has inspired countless young girls and women to pursue careers in STEM fields. It's like the movie was a rocket ship, launching a whole new generation of scientists and engineers into the stratosphere. I hope you're feeling inspired and ready to learn more about these incredible women. It's important to recognize the contributions of black women in history because their stories have been overlooked and ignored for far too long. It's like they were playing a game of hide and seek, but instead of being found, they were left behind. But we can change that. By learning about the stories of Katherine Johnson, Mary Jackson, Dorothy Vaughn, and other hidden figures, we can shine a light on their achievements and inspire future generations to pursue their passions. And let's not forget about the importance of diversity and inclusion in STEM fields. We need more women and people of color in these fields to bring new perspectives and ideas to the table. It's like the more pieces we have in a puzzle, the clearer the picture becomes. So I encourage you to do some research, read some books, watch some documentaries, and learn more about the hidden figures of black women in history and STEM fields. And don't forget to subscribe and like the video, because together, we can make sure these stories are never hidden again.